let's talk about how you can use the Shrink Fatten tool to make radical changes to your models and get swiftly and quickly the kind of look that you're looking for. Let's get into it. The Shrink Fatten tool essentially takes polygons or edges and it scales them along their normals. This makes it a little bit different from the scale tool, and I'm going to use this tire that you see here to demonstrate the point. Let's just go into edit mode and have these polygons selected already. And so what I can do is I can click down here on Shrink Fatten. And then what I can do is I can just pull this little yellow lever out here, just a little bit more like that. And then if you have a look at that now, it's actually fattened up the actual tire itself and these little edges that you can see along here. If I undo that, if we go back and I select everything again, just get on there. That's what we've got this time. That is using the fatten part of the Shrink Fatten tool. I can go the other way and make it smaller, although it would make this particular model look a bit weird. But that is essentially what Shrink Fatten does. Let's talk about push-pull, which is a sub-feature in Shrink Fatten. So go into edit mode. I'm on Shrink Fatten here. And then I just left-click and drag down onto push-pull. I've already got some faces selected here. And I'll show you how this works. So I have this yellow lever again, and when I pull it out, it pulls faces in, or verts or edges. And when I push it in, it pushes those faces out. Very, very simple, very straightforward. Okay, let's talk options. So I'm gonna go back into edit mode, go back to Shrink Fatten. I'm gonna start making a selection. I'm gonna pull this out a little bit, just fatten things up. Okay, great. So first of all, you can change your offset here just by pulling that out or pushing it in. Okay, quite straightforward. You can use offset even if you want to give it more thickness doing your movements. Okay, and then the next thing that you can do is choose proportional editing. And that's very useful because when you start to make changes using proportional size here, you just watch the mesh as I slowly increase this. See, it has an effect on the rest of the mesh as it pushes it out and pushes it in. Slowly pull that in. Now, of course, that always depends on what you've chosen, depends on the type of fall off that you have, but that's important to know. Shrink Fatten behaves similarly to Extrude Along Normals and also just scaling in general, but there are a couple of key differences. The best way to think about it is that Shrink Fatten, rather than scaling your model up or extruding it, it simply inflates it or deflates it. And it's still pushing the verts and the edges along their normals. But when you use it in the right context, you get the right sort of finish that maybe you're looking for. So this inflation deflation viewpoint is really what you should have in mind. Point to be aware of is that there's a fair bit of information that I've seen online, at least, which talks about the fact that push-pull works by moving out or towards the point of origin. That's true in terms of the sense of the object, but the point of origin is normally referred to as this little orange circle that you can see in the middle. And true to form, if I do it right now, you'll notice that it acts around that point. But I'm going to show you something. I'm going to go and move this across here. I am then going to set my origin to the 3D cursor, which is here. I go back on my object, and then let's do push-pull again. See? The point of origin is moved, but it's still happening within the central part of the object. So be wary of that with push and pull. The connected option, when this is ticked, it makes sure that objects that are not, that may be part of the mesh, but are not connected by edges or vertices, don't get affected. So let's increase that so we get more of an effect. So you can see there that the rim is being affected as well. Select all those faces, then I can separate by selection. And what I can do is I can join them. Now they're not connected as a mesh. Okay, so if I then go to Shrink Fatten, I'm gonna select this whole ring, then I go to proportional editing and turn on connected. Then I affect it. The rim is not being affected because it's part of the same mesh, but it's not connected by vertices. I think the only other thing I would say is when you are working with this tool, it's also very good for creating a cage very quickly. Okay, so all you have to do there is basically just duplicate your object. No, don't do it there. Duplicate, and we got our duplicate, and then we can go into edit mode, select absolutely everything, go to Shrink Fatten, which we're already on, and then you can just pull out ever so slightly, like that. Okay, and you can come out of that, and when you compare your two, you've got one which is just slightly bigger than the other. So thanks very much for watching. If you liked the video, then please give it a like or a dislike if you think it wasn't right for you. More than anything, it'd be great if people could follow and could also comment on the video. Let me know what you think of these. I'm going to keep trying improving them in the future, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.